Welcome to Roughing It with Ruth, the channel where everything is a bit rough around the edges. The Manduca Baby Carrier is made from hemp and cotton. It can be used from newborn up until 20 kilograms and it costs 2,050 rand. In addition to having an elastic safety loop, the hip belt buckle also has a system where you can only open it using two hands. The shoulder straps have compression straps at the top for resizing or breastfeeding. The sleep hood attaches using elastic loops and rolls away into its own velcroed pocket. This gives a very neat finish if you're not using the sleep hood. The torso panel can be adjusted by opening or closing a zip. This carrier has the newborn insert built in. When you're not using it, it rolls away underneath some elasticated straps, and when you are using it, you attach it to the outside of the torso section using press studs. There are two different press stud settings for the newborn insert. This teddy bear gives you an idea of how your newborn will fit into the insert. Their face will be towards your chest. The buckles of both the shoulder straps and the hip belt are padded with extra material. There's a central pleat at the bottom of the torso section to help your child sit in a deeper fashion. The buckles on the shoulder straps are designed so that to shorten them, you need to pull in an upwards direction instead of down and back like a lot of other carriers. This makes it a lot easier to tighten them effectively. Because of the long elasticated loops on the sleep hood, I find this sleep hood much easier to attach by myself than many other carriers. This carrier is also very lightweight and packable, so it's quite a good idea for travel. Unfortunately, one of the things that makes it so lightweight and packable is the fact that the shoulder straps are quite narrow and the carrier overall doesn't have a lot of padding. And while the buckles on the shoulder straps are a joy to do up, they can be a little bit tough to get undone if you're not used to the way that they work. The hip belt is also quite a stiff piece of material, which some people might find uncomfortable. And that lovely bit of padding that cushions the buckle on the shoulder strap can bunch up in a strange way if you happen to put the buckle all the way through the safety elastic before tightening it. This is easily fixed, but it is something to keep in mind. The other thing that I've found pretty irritating about this carrier is the belt loop system that they have for tucking away the excess strap you have left over after adjusting. It's quite difficult to feed the straps through these little elastic loops, and if the strap is not long enough after you've adjusted it, then it can't even reach the loop. So I'm not quite sure if this is the best design feature. Overall though, I'm actually a really big fan of this carrier. If you've used the Manduca carriers and you have an opinion about them, please leave me a comment below.